This is the Raised with Jesus podcast, and it is fitting, therefore, that we look a little bit at Romans chapter 6, where Paul says that you have been buried with Christ in your baptism, and you have been raised with him in that same baptism. You've got your daily Lenten devotion from Romans chapter 6, verse 4. We were therefore buried with Jesus through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. Romans chapter 6, verse 4. Paul also writes in 1 Corinthians 12, "Now the body is not made up of one part, but of many. As it is, there are many parts, but one body. Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is a part of it." From 1 Corinthians 12. The hand wields a comb or brush. The eye guides its progress. The hair complies. Fingers tie shoelaces, buttons, zip winter coats. The diaphragm inhales air. The vocal cords emit tones that the tongue and the mouth shape into words. What a wonderful body, working together as each part cooperates. Sore feet, a stiff elbow, carpal tunnel, arthritis, glasses, dentures. When a part of the body begins to break down, whether from use or disease, abuse, misuse, or lack of use, the whole body hurts with it. A toothache makes one irritable. A sore hip darkens one's day. Some athletes, surgeons, and actresses, and rock stars understand this so well that they ensure their trademarks. Keith Richards, for example, lead guitarist and founding member of the Rolling Stones, has insured his hands for $1.6 million. If, or when, he loses the use of his hands, Richards will lose the function that has made him rich and famous. That's how closely we are united to Christ through your baptism. We are members of his body, hands and feet. He has assembled us, bought us, and insured us with his holy precious blood and with his innocent suffering and death. So complete is our identification with the Lord that we shared his tomb because he shares our humanity. Our being baptized into his death is not a metaphor, a picture, or a symbol. It is literal, spiritual reality. You recognize, of course, that spiritual realities are reality too, and no less real for being unseen. And so when Paul writes, "We were therefore buried with Jesus through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life," he says that as members of his body, you have been buried, you have been raised, and now you live. We pray. Jesus, my Redeemer, lives. I, too, unto life shall waken. Endless joy my Savior gives. Shall my courage then be shaken? Shall I fear, or could the head rise and leave his members dead? Grant me a firm knowledge and trust in this truth. Amen. That prayer, of course, from the hymn, "Jesus Christ, My Sure Defense." God bless your day.